Hey, welcome to my channel, and I hope you're here because you were asking the question, why when my steam boiler runs, there's no pressure on my gauge? Now, the one answer to that question could be that the gauge is defective. The other answer could be that the steam siphon, or what is more colloquially known as a pigtail, is clogged, and that would mean that there's no pressure showing on the gauge. It really doesn't can't sense it. But in general, the answer is that the gauge really isn't designed for showing the operating pressure or the real operating pressure of a typical early 20th century steam heating system in North America. It's really there for safety. The definition of low pressure in North America is defined as about 15 psi or less. And so the American Society of Mechanical Engineers says that you've got to have a pressure relief valve on here of that will open up at 15 psi g. And have the correct capacity for the particular boiler it's attached to. And all this lawyerese and stuff like that, but mainly the tag here is very important. You want, if you're running a low pressure steam boiler, can't be more than 15 psi. So why is the gauge double the pressure? Well, it's again for safety. Well, what happened is if you ran up to 15 psi on a 15-pound gauge, it might go all the way around to zero. And if you looked at it just glancing and didn't really pay attention to what side that pointer is on the post there, you would it would appear that it was reading zero when in fact it was about to blow up. So the American Society of Mechanical Engineers dictated that any low-pressure steam boiler, or any steam boiler, or any pressure vessel must show twice the maximum working pressure. Now, the thing about these particular type of gauges, which I believe are called a Burdon tube gauge, is that they tend to only be accurate within the middle third. And at the lower end of the scale, it's not going to be all that accurate. So really, if you're operating at 2 pounds or less, which is what you should be, and that they've known that since 1899, this will barely be off the gauge, and every radiator in the building should be smoking hot all the way from stem to stern, top to bottom. So this is the pressure limiting device, and as you can see, as usual, it is the PA404A, and as usual, it comes fully engaged, and it is up to the installer to make sure that it is cranked down to the lowest possible setting, which is a maximum of 1.5 pounds. Now, if you have a system that has stuff like that on your steam system, then what you're going to need is a vapor stat. Now, this is an old-fashioned vapor stat that's from the surplus market. They don't make them like this anymore. They don't have mercury in them. They don't have this lovely bulb in them. But these tend to work very well. The newer ones, not so much. And you can see here that the pressure is in ounces, 16 ounces, and that's as high as that this thing can go. And that's what the operating pressure of a typical two-pipe vapor system is designed. So this thing would never show any pressure. If it does, either the gauge is defective, the sight glass is clogged, and the pressure has gotten in but can't get out. That I've seen that happen where it's just, or the gauge is defective and it's showing like 10 pounds or something, and it's stuck in that location. So there is nothing in the law that this has got to be here by code, but there is nothing in the law which precludes you from adding another low pressure gauge, which will operate, in ounces and show you the operating pressure of your system. That is why this is a 30-pound gauge on a 15-pound system, which is designed to operate at a half a pound, is just merely there as a hole plugger. Generally, what we do is we remove this gauge and blow and make sure the pigtail is clear as a startup measure. I hope that answered your question. If it did not, please go put your question below. Remember, please to like and subscribe to bring this video up on YouTube's algorithm. Otherwise, it'll be buried and lost, and people might not be able to get this information. Thank you again, and I hope that you have a safe day.